and good anchorage coming down. And this beautifully restored vehicle, it's on loan to us from one of the drivers who's in there at the moment, and it's been restored as it would have been used about the same time as that Atlantis fleet was being tackled in North Africa. It's actually British colours. So again, one of those vehicles. Right for life, if we're looking at those late war German tanks, of course, the Germans, not a match for the late war German tanks, one on one, like the Panther, the Tiger, or the King Tiger. But the Americans never intended it to be. They saw this tank as a breakout weapon. Think of it almost again like a cavalry tank. It's supposed to be speedy. It's got a good fuel purpose gun, the original 75mm. It could fire on a piercing or high explosive. And by the way, if you bumped into tanks, you weren't supposed to fight them. That was supposed to be the tank destroyers. Now that theory broke down fairly quickly in North Africa, but the British troops thought the Germans fantastic. We were the first guys to use the German action in the Battle of El Alamein. And again, it's commented on for being reliable, for being having a great gun on it. And this particular model's got that higher velocity 76mm gun. And later in the war, they were able to provide it with high velocity, armor piercing ammunition that gave this gun almost the equivalent of the firepower of the Panther. So again, careful when we just denigrate the Sherman. Yes, the armor plate on it was certainly not as thick as some of that German material, but the gun.